a step in the right direction there. We'll see consumers get better prices eventually as competition stiffens. Well, we want to get into that conversation on what's happening in tourism levy collection and really what is in store for operators in the tourism sector. And we are now joined by the Chief Executive Officer for the Tourism Fund, Joseph Cherutoi. Many thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Wanakana.
Well, let me just start on a rather light note. Easter is here, and domestic tourists are quite 50-50 about where to go. Perhaps as the Tourism Fund, any projections?
Thank you. I want to appreciate first KTN for giving me this opportunity to come and discuss what we do as Tourism Fund. Just before I talk about the domestic tourism and where tourists can go, let me start by giving you the purpose and object of the existence of Tourism Fund.
All right.
Tourism Fund, initially it was called a Catering and Tourism Development Levy Trustees, popularly known as Catering Levy, which was started way back in 1972.
Yes.
In 2011, the Act was revealed. So we came up with Tourism Act 2011. And the mandate of formerly Catering and Tourism Development Levy Trustees was expanded. And therefore, the name was changed to Tourism Fund. And the purpose of Tourism Fund is seven of them, but I'll also mention three. First is to finance the development of tourism products and services in Kenya. Number two is to finance marketing of Kenya as a tourism destination through Kenya Tourism Board. Mm-hmm. And then number three is training and capacity building in the hospitality industry to train young Kenyans who want to actually work in the hospitality industry through Kenya Utali College. Mm-hmm. So we do this by collecting levy from establishments and entertainment joints and pubs and fillers and all this, so that we use the money now to do the activities I've mentioned. Mm-hmm. Now, when you discuss about the domestic tourism, in the past we have had challenges as far as tourism is concerned, and what I would say is that we have received a lot of support from the locals, mm-hmm. our Kenyan people,
all right,
of course, and of course from the region. Mm-hmm. And when we had challenges in terms of advisories and all this, our levy has been going up. You may not understand this.
Talk to us about the numbers, the statistics.
Yes. In the last 3 years, 2013, 2014, we collected 1.6 billion. 2014, 2015, we collected 1.8 billion. 2015, 2016, 2.1 billion. So you see there's growth. And the reason for this is because of the support we receive from the domestic tourists. Let me tell you, even as we approach the Easter, I wanted to take my family to Masai Mara, but I could not get space. That tells you the support, the immense support we receive from our Kenyans.
Yeah.
We may not feel this, but I would want to point out that Kenyans are actually patronizing the products which we have here in Kenya.
Interesting.
And this is growing.
Good news for that. And sorry to take you back a bit. So what informed the change of name and the rebranding to now become Tourism Fund from Catering Levy?
I indicated that initially the funds which we collect from establishments was actually basically meant for just training and capacity building.
All right.
That was it,
okay.
Basically. Then later on now, after the establishment or the enactment of Tourism Act 2011, the mandate of the body was expanded.
Okay.
And I had mentioned that there are seven of them. Mm-hmm. So first of all, we are actually mandated to collect the levy and finance the development of tourism products and services. So what we do is we work together with county governments. After devolution, work together with the county governments. The counties will identify the tourism attraction sites. And then we'll come in as a fund in collaboration with them. Of course, we will not finance 100%, but we'll give out part of the money which is supposed to be used to develop those products, of course, through the Ministry of Tourism to finance those developments of those products.
All right.
Number two is now marketing of Kenya as a private tourism destination. You realize that KTB, or Kenya Tourism Board, is 20 years old.
Yeah.
Which means now tourism fund or catering, the initial catering and tourism development level trustees was there before the establishment of Kenya Tourism Board.
Yeah.
And the reason why Kenya Tourism Board was established is to specifically market Kenya as a private tourism destination.
Okay.
So this now, after the enactment of Tourism Act 2011, mm-hmm. then when the mandate was expanded to include now marketing, mm-hmm. and that is why now there was need for us to change the name
right.
then to brand, so that we showcase that we are able to do more than aquatic capacity building and training.
Okay.
Yes.
And if you look at the country as of now, tourism hasn't been performing pretty well as compared to, let's say, 5 years ago. Of course, this is linked to different factors. We had the terrorism attacks. We've had Ebola outbreak in West Africa that affected Kenya Airways to some extent. Right now, majority of people we've asked on social media whether the funds collected have been utilized in the best way. So far, if I'm to check out my Twitter handle, I'm seeing only from the people who have voted, they're saying, let me just get that. Actually, 85% are saying no. The funds collected as levies and taxes haven't been utilized properly. 15% are saying yes. What do you think about these numbers? Is it a harsh indictment towards tourism fund?
You know the thinking of the people who know us and the people who have contributed in terms of talking about that we have not utilized the funds properly. That is their own thinking. But I'd want to say that on our side, we contribute about 45% of the budget of Kenya Tourism Board.
Mm-hmm.
And you've realized that Kenya Tourism Board, apart from marketing Kenya's private tourism this locally, mm-hmm. they also do marketing abroad. They attend international exhibitions and forums like ITB, mm-hmm. WTM, and other forums. And when they go to these exhibitions and these conferences, they are showcasing the tourism attraction sites.
So you're saying you've been doing enough?
We are doing enough. And then at the same time, mm-hmm. Look at the number of students who are being trained through Kenya Utali College. They are even subsidized because of the funds we contribute.
Okay.
So we want to tell Kenyans that, you know, as an institution, we are providing the necessary environment by enabling Kenyans to train through Kenya Utali College, enabling Kenya Tourism Board to actually showcase the interesting sites, the tourism attractions here in Kenya. And of course, we are also partnering with counties again to develop
okay.
products. So we are utilizing utilizing the funds rightly.
Spirited defense there. Of course, we'll look at some of the tweets as we move along. But the feeling out there is the return on investment. For example, people in the grassroots who pay the 2% towards the tourism fund, they feel they have sort of been neglected in terms of the planning, in terms of product rollouts. What are you doing differently this time around to ensure you reach out to more people and expand the scope, really? Because majority of the tourism hotspots are in Mombasa, Naivasha, and a bit of hotels in Nairobi. How can we tap into new areas?
Thank you very much, Abby. What we are saying is we have not actually exploited some of the attractions, most of the attractions were in most of the counties. You have rightly said that we market Mombasa coast region, and we partner some of the hotels in Nairobi and Naivasha. But other available opportunities outside those three areas we have mentioned, mm-hmm. they are very attractive sites. What we are saying is we are working very closely with the Kenya Tourism Board, even as we go around creating awareness with our stakeholders mm-hmm. on what we have and what we are planning for them.
Okay.
We work together very closely with the Kenya Tourism Board so that they are also be able to shout and market those products, because once we have provided the enabling environment by financing and those tourism products, we it is now them to come and work with us so that they are able to actually showcase and say these counties which have not been opened up,
yeah.
which have not been marketed, they are able to market. At the same time, working together with Kenya with the Legal College, we also have to provide what we call refresher courses, because apart from offering the mainstream training for young Kenyans who want to work in the hospitality industry, we directly now work with establishments by providing short refresher courses for a week, for 3 days, mm-hmm. even for 2 weeks, so that they have a feel that we are giving back to them, so that instead of sending somebody to train for 1 year or 2 years, We build their capacity by actually taking them for those youth courses opening up. And then at the same time, there are some products which we are developing. Like, for instance, in the next financial year, 2017-2018, mm-hmm. we are going to carry out a feasibility study to establish a cable car in Elgeyo Marakwet and Baringo. And this one now will open up the no-trip cycle. And doing that, we have Kenyans who will be doing safaris like from like Kibia, Samburu, through Baringo, and then Elgeyo Marakwet, and then even to the lake region, visiting even attractive sites like the Kakamega Forest and the like.
Okay.
So when we do this, we will be creating the enabling environment by establishing products which can be attractive to our tourists, both local and internationally. And then now, the people, the owners of this establishment now okay. love a feel that all we are right. actually giving back to them.
All right.
Thank you.
I'd like to get your final word, and what's your outlook for the tourism sector now that you're going into an election year?
I think the message is, as Kenyans, this is our country. Let us conduct our campaigns in a manner which is very visible, and the day of voting is one day, it's a one-day event. And if we, if we conduct our elections, our campaigns in such a way that we are going to scare away our tourists, then we are going to suffer as a country. So I would want to appeal to politicians that let us conduct this election peacefully, so that we don't scare away tourists. And because the gains which we have made now, up to now, are actually very enormous. So, adversities have been lifted and all this. So let us not scare away again, so that we revert back to those adversities again.
All right.
So we'll wish that we conduct our elections peacefully, then now, so that the conducive environment will be able to attract tourists as it were.
Many thanks, Joseph Cherute.
Thank you.
Pleasure having you.
Thank you very much.
Wish you all the best in your endeavors at the Tourism Fund. That has been Joseph Cherutoi, the Chief Executive Officer for the Tourism Fund, just sharing with us some of the key developments that have continued to happen in the tourism sector, especially when it comes to how best are they utilizing money that they collect as tourism levy from players in the tourism sector. He's quite optimistic, saying that this year offers quite a